Hi everyone, are you a business owner or freelancer struggling with late payments, lost invoices, or the stress of tracking everything manually? I know exactly how that feels. I used to be in that situation. Things changed when I created my own invoice tracker. It completely transformed the way I manage invoices, helped me stay organized, reduce late payments, and made running my business much more efficient. In today's video, I will show you step by step how to build your own invoice tracker in Excel. Here's what the template looks like. It lets you enter the invoice details such as invoice number, invoice date, customer name, job description, amount due, invoice due date, payment date. The built-in formulas automatically calculate the balance and the status for each invoice. I have also done a tutorial before on creating a simple invoice template. You can check that out if you are interested. For this demonstration, we will start with a blank spreadsheet. First, add a title at the top. Let's call it Invoice Tracker. Make the title bold and increase the font size so that it stands out. Next, leave a blank row, then create your column header. Start with invoice number for you to input the invoice number. Next, create a column for the invoice date. Create a column for the customer name. For the customer name, you can set up a drop-down list so that you can select the customer name directly from the drop-down list. To do this, we need to create a tab called customer list and input all the customer name in a column. You may also add the other customer details such as the email address, phone number, and their address. Then go back to the main sheet, select the cells under the customer name, go to data, select data validation, select list for the criteria, and select the sources of the customer name. So we go to customer list tab and select the column with the customer name and click OK. So now you can select the customer name instead of typing it manually. Create a column for the job description so that you can write a simple description for the job of the invoice. Adjust the column according to the text that you need to input. Create a column for inputting the amount due, which is the amount of the invoice. If you want to change the number format into the currency, select the column, go to the number format, select your preferred currency or your currency accounting format and click OK. Create a column for the due date of the invoice. Create a column called invoice send. This column is for you to input either yes or no. Under the invoice send column, create a drop down with yes or no options. To do this, same as before, go to data validation, select list for the criteria and type yes and no. So now you can select either yes or no under the invoice send column so that you know that whether you have sent the invoice to your customer or not. Create a column for the amount paid and the paid date. Next, create a column for balance, status, and remarks. For the balance column, we need to input a formula. The formula is equal the amount paid minus amount due. For the status column, we need to input a formula so that it will show different statuses such as unpaid, partially paid, fully paid, and overpaid. To do this, we need to create a blank sheet that shows these four payment statuses. Then go back to the main sheet, create a formula using if formula. For the first condition, if the amount paid equal to zero, we want to show unpaid. Next, if the amount paid is less than the amount due, we want to show partially paid. For the third condition, if the amount paid equal to the amount due, we want to show that is fully paid. And the last condition, if the amount paid is more than the amount due, we want to show overpaid. In front of the if formula, we want to add another if formula. Use is blank. Let's say if the column B is blank, we don't want to show any statuses. If the column B is not blank, we want to use the formula to determine the payment statuses. To make it even clearer, let's use conditional formatting on the status column. To do this, select the cell under the column L, go to conditional formatting, select new rule. Under the style, select classic, select format only cells that contain, select cell value equal to. First, we do it for the unpaid invoice. Let's select unpaid. Select custom format. For the unpaid invoice, we want to use the red text. select the red color, dark red color text, and select bold for the font. For the background color, select the light red color and click OK. So let's say if the amount paid is zero, it will automatically show unpaid status with the red color to show an urgency. So we need to further modify this conditional formatting. Let's go back to conditional formatting, select manage rules. We want to apply the conditional formatting throughout the cells under column L. So we need to modify here into column L, all the cells under column L, and select tick. Next, create a conditional formatting for partially paid. To do this, just duplicate the rules, then edit rules. For this, we select partially paid. Then we want to change the color of the cells of partially paid. Go to custom format. For partially paid, select the light yellow background. For the text, select the yellow, the dark yellow, or the orange to show a warning so that you know that there's a payment not yet fully received. Select OK. Next, create a conditional formatting for fully paid. Here, select fully paid. Then, select custom format. For the fully paid, use a dark green text with a light green background. Next, do this again for the fully paid status. Click duplicate rule, select edit rule, select fully paid. Change the color of fully paid. For fully paid, use the dark green text and the light green background. And lastly, for the overpaid, you can also use the green but with a lighter style. For example, for the font, instead of a bold font, you can just use the regular font so that it's not confused with fully paid. Then click OK. After all the conditional formatting rules are done, just click OK. Now we need to populate the rest of the cells in column L with the customized status formula. Before doing this, we need to use absolute references for the four payment status cells by adding dollar signs to the reference. This will ensure that when we drag the formula, the reference remains the same. Add dollar signs to both the column and row of the reference cell. After that, click enter. Now you can drag the formula down to populate the cells in column L with the customized formula. Do this for the status column, balance column, invoice sent column. And the customer name column as well. We can also slightly make the header look a little bit distinct by applying some color into it and make the text a little bit bold or even increase the size of the text. You may change the color of the text as well. So this is how the invoice tracker looks like after you have input some data into it. If you would like to see how to build extra dashboard like monthly overview, customer overview, and annual overview, let me know in the comments below. If you prefer to save time, I have also created a ready-made invoice tracker templates available in Excel and Google Sheets. You can find the links in the description or comments section below. Thanks for watching. If you found this tutorial helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you in the next video.